Welcome to this video presentation of preparing microscope slides. Is that what we're doing today?
I think that's what we're doing, Jeff.
I quite like the microscope that we did last week, but we sort of went through the preparing the slide real quick, and I figured we should learn how to make slides.
Very good idea.
Is there just one way, or?
There's a number of different ways. We're going to look at three ways, besides those three, there's a number of very specialized ones that often use heat and special dyes, but we're going to look at three different ways that we can look at three very different types of specimens.
Right on. What do we get to look at?
The first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a real quick sample of pond water.
Pond water?
Yeah, and within that water there's
I'm not sure if I want to drink that.
I wouldn't drink it, but it sure is fun to look at. So we'll make a sample of pond water. The next thing that we'll do is we'll take this onion and we'll make a small sample of the really thin skin on the onion, and hopefully we can see some plant cells.
Okay.
And the third thing that we're going to do is we're actually going to look at some of your cells that make up your body.
You're going to cut things off me?
We're going to hack you apart.
right on.
Sounds fun.
I'm in. Let's start with that one. No.
Let's save the best for last.
Okay.
Okay, so first thing we'll do is we'll take the pond water and we're
going to
need one of the glass slides.
Slides. Okay.
And
are these disposable slides?
Yeah, they're disposable.
Are they?
So we can throw them away, and you're going to want to make sure that in the lab you dispose of them in the right place.
This one looks dirty.
Well, let's get a clean one.
Perfect.
Something else to make sure, and this is very important, when you grab a slide, quite often they stick together.
Right.
And if they stick together and we try to put them under the microscope, it's going to cause the lenses to bump.
So always make sure you only have one.
Slide, yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay.
I got one.
If you want to put it on your staining tray, the slide, yeah, that's a little slide holder.
This is fun.
And it frees up both of your hands. If you want to grab one
that's
of these
eyedroppers. An eyedropper. Okay.
And then what we'll do, Jeff, is we will get a sample out of the pond water. And a really good place to go is right to the very, very bottom.
Bottom.
That's because a lot of the things have settled out.
So now this is like chemistry, so I maybe should squeeze this before I go in?
Probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I squeeze this before I go in?
Yeah, and go right to the bottom.
Get right to the bottom to get some floaties.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
okay,
then
I got some stuff.
Then if you can get one drop on the middle of the slide.
Just one?
Just one, yeah.
All you need is one.
Just one. Any more than it's a lot of cleanup.
Beautiful. Okay, I have one. Off to the microscope?
Not quite yet. We have to put a cover slip on it first.
Oh, right. Do I just use another one of these?
No, they're a little too thick.
Okay.
And again, it'll sort of disrupt the lenses.
Here's my cover slips.
Those are cover slips. They're really thin pieces of glass.
They're sort of rectangular, so it doesn't matter which side.
It does, because they really only fit one way, so you're going to want to make sure that it's lengthwise.
Lengthwise, same as the slide.
Yeah, and then there's a sort of a rule of thumb that we follow to put the cover slip down. We usually put it at about a 45-degree angle.
45?
Yeah, and then you can just gently lay it down.
Gently lay it down.
Yeah, what should happen is that drop of water should disperse and get rid of most air bubbles.
No, I didn't get it right.
Can I still move it?
Okay.
Something else that you'll want to do is make sure that it's dry. Quite often, if you have too much water, it runs over the edge and it'll stick to the stage.
Okay, so I just put it on here?
Yeah, simple paper towel.
Put it on here and just sort of dab it?
Sure.
I don't want to hit it too hard.
Not too hard.
Just sort of dab. Blot. Yeah.
Yes, and you can see some of the water starting to soak up.
I do see some of the water.
Yeah.
Okay,
so
good.
Now you have a slide that you're ready to look at.
That was real easy.
That was very easy.
Are the other ones harder?
A little bit, but not much. You could do it, Jeff.
Okay, I like that one. So I just put a slide on.
Yeah, we'll start with another slide again.
Put my pond water, whatever it is, put my cover slip on, and then dry anything, and then off I go to the scope.
You're ready to go.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay, good. Now what happens if I forget which slide I have? Should I label those things?
Sometimes that's not a bad idea if you're making more than one slide.
Okay. All right, good. We're on to our next one.
Slide number two.
New slide. Oh, like I got 10 that time. Okay, here's just one. I got one. Okay,
now we're going to try and look at a piece of onion. And the light microscope is set up to look at very, very thin slices. We only want to get a few cell layers there.
So I can't just take a hunk out of it?
No, not the big hunks, but there's that real fine skin. So if you can just take a little piece of that and either cut or peel it off.
Can I use these?
You sure can. That's what they're there for.
Okay. So I can just take some scissors.
Yeah, and the smaller the better here, Jeff.
The smaller the better.
Yeah. Perfect.
These are good scissors.
They are.
I wonder if they cut hair.
I don't think you have that problem, buddy.
Okay, so how do I get this? I can see there's a little piece on my scissors. How do I get it over there?
That you're going to have to use some ingenuity, and quite often you might want to use one of those other tools in there just to put it on. But before we do that, Jeff, we probably want to lay some water down.
Oh, right.
These are all called wet mounts, and they use water to keep the cover slip on, and
sterile
also to
water.
Nicely spread the specimen out.
Okay, so I put that first before the specimen.
Yeah, it probably works better that way.
Okay.
It's a little bit easier to get the specimen off.
Dab in the middle?
Yeah, one, perfect.
Dab in the middle. Now take this, see if I can get that off. Uh-oh, can I push it over?
You sure can.
Just as long as it gets in the water somewhere, hey?
Somewhere in the middle.
There we go.
Very good.
Is that too big or is that one?
No,
okay?
That's perfect.
Okay. Oh, cover slip.
Yes.
Right? I bet you can get more of these than one at a time.
Yeah.
And I do my 45 degree angle thing again.
And then gently lay it down. You see how everything disperses and there's no air bubbles in there?
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah.
Okay, now I have to do this again.
So you could blot that dry and that would be ready to look at once you're finished doing that.
Oh, I'm getting good at this.
Did you get paid to do this?
No.
You should.
You think I could be a research? Oh, that's a good one.
I like it.
I'll bet you could see some onion cells there. My eyes are starting to water.
Well, let's get rid of this then.
Okay, so this is slide number two.
That's slide number two.
I'm good with that. I can use scissors. Okay, now you said you were going to cut me up.
Okay, I'm actually going to let you do that.
Oh,
I'm not
going
to cut you, Jeff. I won't do that to you. But what we're going to try and do is get some epithelial cells from the inside of your cheek.
Oh.
Okay, and in order to get those, we're going to get a great big butcher knife.
And, I do have a knife.
We need a toothpick.
Oh, here's some toothpicks.
There's toothpicks right there.
Okay.
And you're probably going to want to get your slide set up first.
Oh, before I get my thing out?
Yeah.
All right. So slide.
One slide.
Slide. Two slides.
See how easy it is for them to stick?
They are easily to stick. So there's one.
Okay.
Should I put my water on first?
Yeah, I would start with a little drop of water.
A little dab will do you. Not that
I like grill cream.
Not that I ever used that. My dad used to. Okay, now what do I do with this?
And you're going to want to take that big flat side, and you're going to want to rub it on the inside of your cheek.
Okay.
Okay, and in doing so, hopefully dislodge some of those cells.
This won't hurt?
It shouldn't.
Okay. Oh. Is that enough yet?
Yeah, give it another scrape.
Oh.
I'll bet that's good.
Oh, that feels quite good. Maybe I'll do the other side too. Okay, I think I'm good enough. Okay, now I just put this in the water?
Yeah, you're going to want to sort of swirl that water around.
With this toothpick?
Yeah, with your toothpick and get some of those cells into the water.
Oh, I can see some.
Yeah, there's going to be cells in there for sure.
I got plenty in there. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm good there.
Now what we're ready to do is we're ready to put a cover slip on.
Cover slip? I'm getting good at the cover slips. I just have one. 45 again?
45.
Is there another way that I should put these cover slips on?
If you're having a hard time with the real small glass cover slips, you could probably take one of those probes.
Yeah.
And use it to lower the cover slip.
Oh, so put it at my 45.
45.
And then put this underneath
it. And then gently lower it down.
Oh.
Wow, you are a quick learner,
I'm quite
Jeff.
Good at that,
you
too.
Are.
Okay, dabble, do you? Right?
Okay. We can clean that up a little bit. Now, Jeff, our body cells are, for the most part, almost transparent. So if we were to just look at them, they'd be difficult to see. So what we're going to do is we're going to stain them using a stain called methylene blue.
I'm glad you're staining them after you got them out of my mouth.
Well, we could have did it first.
No, that's good. Okay, so I'm staining with methylene blue. Let me get some of this other stuff out of the way. Okay, here's my thing. And so, like I've already put the cover slip on, how's this going to work?
What we're going to do is we're going to put a drop of slide on the edge of the cover slip. And then what's going to happen is that the water and the dye are going to stick together because they're cohesive.
All right.
And some of that dye should run in under the cover slip. We need very little.
Sort of the diffusion effect.
Yes, very much so.
Okay. Okay. So.
And I'd put that on our slide holder.
Slide holder?
Yeah.
I don't need to put it at an angle? I just put it on?
Yeah, just put it on. And one little drop. You don't need a lot. And you'll notice it should move in.
This is in my way.
Really quickly.
drop. Oh yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just sucking right through.
And if it doesn't move or it slows down to the point where it's not completely moved across your cover slip, you can take a piece of paper towel and you can put it on the other side of the cover slip, and that'll start to draw some of the water out there, and in doing so, it'll pull
the other stuff,
stain the rest of the...
Well, that's an interesting... Yeah. Can I try that?
I would try it. See if
it looks like it's already coming pretty good, but...
You're so good, you don't even need the paper towel.
Oh, look at that draw. Yeah, very cool.
You can see it's actually went right to the paper towel now.
Yeah, it did. You think that's good enough to look at?
We could look at it, but we're going to want to clean that one up. And that's probably even more so true with the stains than it is with just water.
Yeah, because I put a bunch on the side there. Okay, so same kind of idea.
Yeah, just blot that nice and dry. Make sure you get all the methylene blue off.
Is it okay if I tap it a bit?
It is, yeah. You don't want to tap it too hard.
But it's not going to mess up the cells
in
there?
No, it shouldn't.
Okay.
Very nice.
Looking beautiful?
It is.
Would you hire me?
Oh, you're hired.
you hesitated there for a minute.
I heard you work for cheap, Jeff.
Okay, I think that's a beautiful slide. Can we look at this
one?
You
sure can. And let's look at Jeff's cells.
Jeff's cells. Okay, here we go. Oh, and there they are. I guess I can look under the microscope, too. We had this prepared beforehand.
Be careful, Jeff.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, can I focus a bit?
I play with the fine focus. We go back to our last episode and rules of using the microscope.
Hey, there's little dots inside there.
What do you think those are, Jeff?
I don't know, maybe peanut butter?
Close. Those are the nuclei of your cells. That's where all of
I was looking
DNA
at my nuclei?
You were. Your DNA is in there.
Well, that's awesome. Well, that was easy. We did three different slides. One with the pond water. We used this little, what did you call this?
An eyedropper.
An eyedropper thing. Put it on the slide, cover slip. And then we did the onion, caught just a little bit. I was interested that I just needed just hardly any.
Yeah, you have to think about the fact, Jeff, that on high power, we're looking at it 400 times its normal normal size. So because of that, you need very, very little.
Just little.
Yeah,
little.
You're going to see individual cells, and they're almost, you can't see them with the naked eye.
Yeah, yeah, so just a little bit. And then I like that doing the thing inside my mouth. I should try
that. That's cool,
that.
Isn't it?
I quite like that. I've thought, well, I'll just sort of grab some skin off my fingers or something, but that was sort of funner.
Yeah, and those cells were, you know, some of them were probably still alive, whereas your outside skin cells are dead, and you wouldn't see near what you'd see here.
Very good. Good. Well, thanks very much, Kelly. That was...
Thank you for having me, Jeff.
I think I'm set on using slides. Thanks.